Alright, so I'm in wisdom from the Rebbe for today. So the Holy Rebbe Levi Yitzchak of Radishev gave a parable for what the idea of shofar is. And he explained the story of a king who was one time traveling in the forest. As he was traveling, he was walking for a while until he actually got lost. And he couldn't make his way back to the palace. He tried asking people for help, but nobody believed him that a simple looking man is actually the king. Finally, one wise man decided he's going to help the king, and he led him back to the palace. And the king was ever indebted to this man. A couple years went by, and this man actually did a sin, a crime against the kingdom, and he was punished with capital punishment. As a last request, he asked that the king should come dressed up wearing those garments that he wore on that day, and this man showed up to the king wearing the garments that he wore back then. When the king saw the setting that he was originally in back then, he was overcome with emotion and said, "I'll grant whatever you'd like. I'm going to pardon this man and save his life." This is what we are doing on Rosh Hashanah. We are reminding God Almighty what happened by Matan Torah, where God Almighty had the Torah, and he tried going to all the nations of the world, tried to give it to someone, but nobody wanted to accept it. Nobody wanted to help God and accept the Torah, until it came to us, the Jewish people. And the Jewish people said to God that we're going to accept it in a way of Nasav and Ishmael. We're going to listen to God's commands no matter what. And this is what we are reminding God by Rosh Hashanah. We blow the sound of the shofar. We remind God of the original setting that we were in back in that days, when the Torah was at a state where it needed somebody to receive it. And we remind God that just like then, he pardoned us and took care of us, so too now, even though we're in a situation where we deserve a punishment, God should save us as well. This is the second aspect of the shofar. We're doing the idea of zichronos, reminding God of all the things that we did in our history so that God will remember us and save us and grant us a very happy, healthy, sweet new year. L'chaim, l'chaim.